Alright, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to another episode of the Casual Side Quest Channel. I am your host, Beesting84, and we shall be continuing the Bioshock Infinite story. And as you know from the last episode, I wasn't exactly happy with the way that episode went. Unfortunately, it was kind of boring, and I think that the edit will do my best to ensure that it's not as boring, but ultimately, I was literally just sitting there, like, running through the level, trying to just make sure that it was relatively interesting, but it really, there was not a lot there that made it that interesting. However, hopefully this one, we are just entering the new Colombia. I assume it's the next portal or whatever it may be. So we're going to see how that works out, and then we're going to hopefully get the guns for Daisy Fitzroy from the other Chen Lin guy. Okay, but we'll figure it out. So let's jump right in. Alright, so now it sounds like this Colombia is about to fall out of the sky because of all the rioting or something. And why can't I see anything? Oh. Can I help you? Alright. Oh, hello, look at all the new people. Anybody interesting? That's not how you spell total. You wanna go home? You're still dead. Okay, I don't understand that, but okay.
Daisy Fitzroy. Come on, you piece of bullshit. Tell me about Daisy. Cut him loose.
What?
Scarfield says cut him loose. Then bring me his tools to the lockup. You've been clean, I guess. Why? What are you? The Columbia Gazette? The chink's wife got friends in high places. Come on. We need to settle.
Honestly, I'm probably about as lost as you are.
Chen Lin is alive now.
We're in a world where he was never murdered. Somewhere we'll find out why, I suppose.
I don't suspect you can change something like that.
Everything else remains. Oh, I finally got the code book. Way back when I needed it back like 2 episodes ago. Okay. Okay, Daisy Fitzroy is still. Michael Cassis. Abernathy Cook is dead, and Morgan Creed. I don't know who Morgan Creed is.
These men.
I killed them. They were dead.
Not in this world. Look at their noses. They're all bleeding.
I'm disgusted. Disgusting. Sick.
Come on, recharge. Yeah, hello!
Patchbooker!
Much obliged!
In the other world, he was the one who was strangled on the rock.
In the other world? This whole business makes my head hurt.
Do tell.
You know, I wasn't born deaf. I hear what it is people are saying. Why is it, Mr. Fink, that we have to work 16 hours a day? Let's be clear. The fact is, I simply can't.
do. Ow, ow. Ah! Here, piggy, piggy, piggy!
What the? Where? What the?
Yeah, that's pretty brutal. Ow, ow! Reload! Oh, come on!
In case you need it. Need this?
That'll do!
I'm really confused of just like what the whole idea, like what everything is going down is and whatnot. So it's like you went to go get Elizabeth, and then you know you got Elizabeth, but trying to get out, you get a job from Daisy Fitzroy to go get guns, and then from there you gotta go see Fink, and then from there it just kind of piles on to each other. It just doesn't really make a lot of sense, but by that same token, it's, you know, it is what it is, I guess. I don't know if that makes...
Found some money.
I don't know if that makes any sense, but...
Great.
It's really just, it's, like, confusing because everybody you're supposed to go see is, like, trying to either A, kill you, or B, the thing, and you can sit there and be like, oh, well, it's, like, you know, it's giving you a test or something, and there's some truth to that, but it just seems like it's kind of gimmicky. Oh, yeah, that's right, this way. Mr. Lin! Aha! And it looks exactly the same.
Do you hear anything?
Huh?
No machines. No tools.
Oh, what does that mean?
He's upstairs now.
Well, what does that mean?
Booker, look. The shrine. It's a figure of Comstock now.
Oh, well, that's just... That's all... Okay, so he's worshipping Comstock. Yay! Which means that Fink is working for the Vox Populi in this world, I guess? Mr. Lin!
Mr. Lin?
Chen Lin? Excuse me, Chen Lin?
Who are you? You speak up! Speak up!
Oh.
Can't hear you over all these machines! Very loud!
I'm Booker DeWitt.
Stand back! These machines very dangerous. Wait downstairs with Mrs. Lin.
Daisy Fitzroy sent us. We need to talk to you about getting some weapons.
Machines very dangerous! No place for stupid people!
To lose pretty head.
Mr. Lin,
downstairs!
What is wrong with him?
Remember him dead in that cell? Maybe in some way he remembers that too. How would you reconcile that?
I don't know.
Well, I'm so glad that they brought me to here and they don't really reconcile how to do that. So I guess we'll go back downstairs, like they said.
Kill my husband? Calm his troubled thoughts. Ease his burden.
Oh, you're white.
Can lend that to me?
That's what it is. That's the
thing. Excuse me, ma'am. Anyway. I'm looking for Mrs. Lin.
Mrs. Lin?
No, I mean a little Chinese lady. She was...
Booker, this is Mrs. Lin. They took Chen's tools. What's he got without his tools?
Well, your husband is a bit out of sorts.
If he could work again, maybe. If he could work, he'd...
Mrs. Lin, can you tell me who took your husband's tools?
Goddamn police. They took them and locked them up in the impound in Shantytown.
Shantytown? What happens? Tools back to fix his mind?
Not getting any guns. Chen Lin doesn't have his tools. Let's head to Shantytown.
So in this world, it's a little bit more accepting that interracial marriages? Because you know that, you know, from the first episode that, you know, interracial marriages in the original Colombia is, you know, frowned upon. Well, I'm not saying it nicely. I mean, when you're about to stone somebody to death, actually, you're about to throw a baseball at him, so... Not exactly the same thing, but it's... You get what I'm saying.
Did you notice? Lynn had a bloody nose.
Seems to be in style.
His terror. I'm not so sure it was...
Pull the lever! Would you say lever? I used to say lever. I say lever and lever. It just depends.
Sorry, I didn't...
It's all right. It's as much a mystery to me as anyone else. Maybe Songbird knows, but he's not talking.
I'm sorry.
What for? I get to wear this stylish thimble to cover up my hideous deformity. I hear they're all the rage in Paris.
Bye-bye. Yeah, it was either do that or don't do that. And I was like, I had more fun doing this way anyway. Fuck. Hold on. Let me switch over to possession. Gone automaton.
Ammo Booker!
Stop right!
Catch Booker!
That'll do.
Thank you. Ow! What the? Left the outside. Oh, okay. Not as good as I hoped, but whatever. Where are you? Whoa! Leave area buttons.
You must think me some sort of freak. A girl who can bring dead men back to life. Whose only acquaintance is a giant bird creature. I must seem ridiculous.
You just got dealt a bad hand.
I am not going back to that tower, no matter what happens.
They won't stop until they have.
Why? What did I do to them?
You frightened them.
Good.
This is what they want, brothers.
Is this bar you're talking about?
Privileged to
spare some coin, friend. Not all of us are gainfully employed down here. And a man's gotta eat.
Cover me. I'm going.
Well, how you like them eagles? Hey, kiddo. I can play the guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, we pause for our massive killing spree to bring you singing.
When you force deep underground, well, you see things from the bottom up. And down at the bottom of the city, I saw a fire burning. The fire's got heat aplenty, but it ain't got no mouth. Daisy. Now she got herself a mouth big enough for all the fires in Colombia.
There's a tear over there.
Open it.
All right.
Plenty of places down below where you'll find more of the same.
Like a wounded knee.
Yeah, like a wounded knee.
Take it! I am a master of pyrotechnics or something. I don't know. Boom! Wow, I can't hit anybody. I need a sniper rifle. Cover, Elizabeth. I mean, it's kind of dangerous, but, you know, do whatever you feel like you need to do.
Catch! Can you open this?
I can do that. All yours.
Alright. Leave this area. Okay, switch to the hand cannon. Worst police lockup impound area ever.
I see him.
Go ahead.
On it.
Cute.
Come on. Why are their eyes glowing?
Some fierce at night, Lady Comstock and a prophet. Never make out what it was about from my bunk, though. After the worst, I seen she ain't left for morning prayer. So I crept upstairs to check in on her. Like a fool, I lingered. Scullery maid was what they called me when I walked into Comstock House. Murderer was what they shouted when I ran out.
There they are, the tools.
Now we just have to get them back to the box, and then we get our airship.
Do it.
Helping by getting guns for the Vox Populi.
It's gonna help us.
Daisy can make a change, can't she? Make things better for the people here.
Sure.
Is this all like
clip? Well, we sure as hell aren't gonna be able to carry all this back.
Holy
to the
crap,
shop.
How the...
I didn't think this all the way through.
What are you gonna do, Elizabeth?
It looks like a tear. To another version of this room that doesn't have any tools in it.
The tools aren't in there,
then they must be
back at the shop.
Walker, if we go into this Terra, I don't think there's any turning back. You sure you want to go now?
Well, let's progress the story. Come on. Open the door.
Back to the gunsmith and finish up. I aim to be on that airship and well shut up this place for a while.
Booker, if the Vox get their weapons, there's going to be a revolution just like Les Miserables. These people are gonna have better lives.
Yeah.
So it's the only thing I can think of is that the worlds are laying on top of each other. Only explanation I can get at this point. Because this is getting more and more confusing with each thing.
You ever see a forest at the beginning of a fire? Before the first flame, you see them possums and squirrels running through the trees. They know what's coming. But the fat bears with their bellies full of honey, well, you can't hardly wake them up from their comfortable hibernation. Going to Emporium, and then we gonna see what it takes to rouse them from their slumber.
Can you feel it? Daisy's moved these people. Things can change, Booker, and we can be a part of it.
I don't want to be a part of it. Once we get our airship, we'll be well shut of this place.
So this is... Ow, what the... Oh, okay. Now they're friends. All right. Well, honestly, by this point, I might as well just stop.
You're Booker DeWitt, the hero of the Vox.
What the hell are they talking about?
Look at that poster. In this world, you're a hero.
The Vox. Slate and I burned down the Hall of Heroes.
Look. Their nose.
Hard to think. Two memories in the same place.
Booker, come back to me. We're going to find Daisy Fitzroy.
We're getting out of here on the First Lady. Let's go.
Shit. They're gonna execute him. Yep. Well, that's just pleasant.
This world, you're a martyr.
These folk need a better class of hero. When it comes down to it, the only difference between Comstock and Fitzroy is a name spell.
Go, Vox! Go!
Do it!
I like her optimism.
I don't know if I brought us to a world where the Vox had weapons, or I created one.
Poor guy just can't catch a break, can he?
Looks like I got a friend in town after all. Slate. He's fell in with these Vox populi. And for irregulars, I will say, they are loaded for bear. Problem is, I gotta help them with their damn revolution first. Then we take Comstock House by storm. I do that, I get the girl.
No, this is not what I meant to have happen.
Elizabeth.
They're dead.
Come on, let's leave this place. Let's go to the factory and get our airship. This isn't our responsibility, none of it. You just opened a door to this world and we stepped through.
Are you sure?
Oh my.
Did I just bring us to a world where Chenlin was alive, or did I create it? I told you, I always thought that my little trick was a form of wish fulfillment.
Oh, that's... Whoa, 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 whoa.
Door open unless someone takes that airship out.
If sabotage the engine and bring this thing down. Sabotage the engine and bring this thing down.
It's hazard pay.
Okay, now to get off this thing.
I have no idea what I just did. I'm not even joking. Yeah, that's cool as it goes down. Let's take a moment and watch this.
That was amazing.
Come on, Elizabeth. Let's go find Daisy in the factory.
We'll go a little bit longer to see. Whoa! What the? We'll go a little bit longer to get to the end of, see if it's gonna be Daisy and see how she gets screwed over.
They're just right for each other, aren't they?
Who?
Fitzroy and Comstock. May Lin? Mr. Lin? My god, I was so set on getting to Paris, I didn't really think that...
You couldn't have known this would happen.
I had a role in this catastrophe. If you want to pretend that we're purely innocents in this, then that's your prerogative, but...
Hello?
Hello, Fink?
I saw you die, Booker. Saw with my own eyes.
Fitzroy. Listen, I got you your guns. I'm here for my airship.
But my Booker DeWitt died for the Vox Populi. You either an imposter or a ghost. My Booker DeWitt was a hero to the cause, a story to tell your children. You just complicate the narrative.
Well, all right then. Are they gonna execute these guys too? Or... Guys, you gonna let me through? Oh, seriously?
Booker, catch!
Ooh, undertow. Let's see what this does. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. So, I'm gonna end this, here. This was incredibly frustrating at this point. I'm gonna see if I can figure out, play it through, and see if I can figure out how to get through. In the meantime, we hope to see you back here at the next Casual Side Quest channel. If you have any comments or questions of what games we should play, or what we should do next, please leave it in the comments below, and we hope to see you back there next time. All right, bye-bye.